Dear students, in this video, I am going to discuss about the topic quantum yield. The efficiency of a photochemical reaction can be expressed in terms of quantum yield or quantum efficiency. It can be defined as the number of molecules reacting per quantum energy absorbed or number of moles reacting per Einstein of energy absorbed. So these two are the definitions of quantum yield. Quantum yield is denoted by the symbol phi. So the quantum yield is the ratio of number of molecules reacting in a given time with that of number of quanta of light absorbed in the same time. With respect to moles, we can also define quantum yield of a photochemical reaction as the ratio of number of moles of reacting substance in a given time divided by number of Einsteins of light absorbed in the same time. So this is the definition of quantum yield. So here in this slide, you can see different photochemical reactions and their quantum yields. For example, in the very first example, dissociation of ammonia quantum yield is 0.2, and formation of thionyl chloride is with quantum number 1. See, there are different quantum yields for different photochemical reactions. In the previous video, we have discussed laws of photochemistry. In case if the Stark-Einstein's law is strictly obeyed for photochemical reactions, then the quantum yield or quantum efficiency of all the photochemical reactions is equal to 1, that is unity. Such quantum yields are considered as normal quantum yields. If quantum yield is equal to 1, then those quantum yields, those photochemical reactions fall under normal quantum yield category. Example, SO2 plus Cl2 gives rise to SO2 Cl2. However, in the previous slide, we have seen many photochemical reactions with different quantum yields. Some are having 10 to the power 4, some are having 0.1, 0.2, and some are having 2. That means in many cases, the quantum yield is found to be higher than 1, and in some cases, it is lower than 1. Such quantum yield is considered as abnormal quantum yield. That is, the quantum yield is not equal to 1, either greater than 1 or less than 1. Such type is considered as abnormal quantum yield. Abnormal quantum yield. Example, formation of hydrogen chloride quantum yield is 10 to the power 4 to 10 to the power 6. That is very high. And the formation of hydrogen bromide is 0.01 quantum yield. That is very, very less. So if the quantum yield is more than 1, then it is known as a high quantum yield. If the quantum yield is less than 1, then it is known as low quantum yield. So this anomalous behavior of quantum yield can be explained on the basis of the fact that a photochemical reaction consists of two processes. Ante oka photochemical reaction jarigindante danlo rendu processes unnayani anukunta anamata. Okati primary process, inkokati secondary process. So primary process lo em jarutundante, one molecule absorbs one photon of light radiation or one quantum of light radiation. So ikkada primary process lo oka molecule maatrame oka photon of light ni absorb cheskuntundi. See, it is there clearly in the statement. Absorption of a photon by a molecule leads to the formation of an activated molecule. The activated molecule formed by the absorption of a photon may or may not react. So ikkada primary process lo oka molecule oka photon of light ni absorb cheskuni activate avutundi. ఈ యాక్టివేట్ అయిన మాలిక్యూల్ రియాక్ట్ అవ్వచ్చు, రియాక్ట్ అవ్వకపోవచ్చు, లేదా డైరెక్ట్గా ప్రోడక్ట్ని ఫామ్ చేయొచ్చు అనమాట. సో నెక్స్ట్ కమ్స్ టు సెకండరీ ప్రాసెస్. సెకండరీ ప్రాసెస్లో ఏం జరుగుతుంది, యాక్టివేట్ అయిన మాలిక్యూల్కి కొన్ని ఛాన్సెస్ ఉన్నాయన్నమాట రియాక్షన్ని కంప్లీట్ చేయడానికి. ద ఫస్ట్ పాసిబిలిటీ ఈజ్ ఇట్ మే రియాక్ట్ టు ఫామ్ ఫైనల్ ప్రోడక్ట్, ఆర్ ఇట్ మే బి పార్ట్లీ ఆర్ కంప్లీట్లీ డియాక్టివేటెడ్ అండ్ దస్ నో ఫర్దర్ రియాక్షన్ అకర్స్, ఆర్ ఇట్ మే కాజ్ ద రియాక్షన్ ఆఫ్ మెనీ మాలిక్యూల్స్ త్రూ అ చైన్ మెకానిజం. సో ఇక్కడ ఫస్ట్ పాసిబిలిటీ చూడండి, ఫైనల్ ప్రోడక్ట్ ఇఫ్ ద యాక్టివేటెడ్ మాలిక్యూల్ డైరెక్ట్లీ గివ్స్ ద ఫైనల్ ప్రోడక్ట్ దెన్ ద క్వాంటమ్ ఈల్డ్ బికమ్స్ 1. ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ డియాక్టివేటెడ్ ద క్వాంటమ్ ఈల్డ్ ఈస్ లెస్ దాన్ 1. ఇఫ్ ఇట్ కాజెస్ మెనీ మాలిక్యూల్స్ టు రియాక్ట్ దెన్ ద క్వాంటమ్ ఈల్డ్ ఈస్ గ్రేటర్ దాన్ 1. సో దిస్ ఈస్ ద రీజన్ బిహైండ్ ద అబ్నార్మల్ క్వాంటమ్ ఈల్డ్. లెట్ అస్ డిస్కస్ ఇన్ డీటెయిల్. The secondary process may take place even in the dark provided the products of the primary reactions are available. Products of the primary reaction means the activated molecules. So only in the primary process light absorption takes place. In the secondary process light absorption does not take place. So the secondary process may take place even in the dark. Okay. Then light radiations are essential only for the primary process. Hence, law of photochemical equivalence is applicable only to the primary process. Then the quantum yield is always equal to 1 for primary process. For primary process, the quantum yield is always 1 for any photochemical reaction. But if the quantum yield is high or quantum yield is low, depends only on the secondary process. If the secondary process occurs, then quantum yield may not be 1. It varies. So let us see the reasons for normal quantum yield. According to Einstein's law of photochemical equivalence, in primary process, each molecule absorbs one quanta of light radiation. Hence, quantum yield is always equal to 1. But what is the reason for high quantum yield? The product of primary process, that is activated molecule, which is formed in the primary process, may collide with the secondary molecule and this activated molecule may transfer its energy to the secondary molecule. And the second molecule may transfer its energy to the third molecule and so on. Thus, the chain reaction starts and number of reacting molecules will be high. That means one molecule is initiating many molecules to react. That means one photon of light is activating many molecules. So due to the formation of this intermediate product, it acts as a catalyst. So exothermic reaction may also activate more number of molecules. The example for high quantum yield photochemical reaction is formation of HCl. H2 plus Cl2 gives rise to 2HCl. The quantum yield for this reaction is 10 to the power 4 to 10 to the power 6. That means for one photon of light radiation, 10 to the power 4 to 10 to the power 6 molecules gets reacted and becomes hydrogen chloride. Coming to the reasons of low quantum yield, in some reactions, deactivation of activated molecules takes place. That means whatever the activated molecule that is formed in the primary process, it may not become product. It may get deactivated and again the reacting substances may, initial reacting substances may form and they react back to form normal reactants. So the example for such quantum yield is anthracene polymerization,